Hatred does not only arise when you do something right, neither is it solely an outcome of your wrong deeds. Hatred is quite personal. However, there are some general attitudes, good and bad, that can make some people hate you. It is important to emphasize that some people hate you does not make you a bad person. The goal is not to be liked by all, but to be a better you. In this article, certain reasons why some people may hate you will be disclosed, and also a few tips on how to work on being a better you will be suggested. If you're an entrepreneur or an ambitious person, we specially invite you to join our motivational channel, which was designed to give you daily inspirations so that you will have the strength to pursue and achieve your most important dreams. We call this channel Hunt TV, and you can join in the description box. 1. Being too truthful. Being truthful is a noble act, but it is one that will put you in a position to be hated. The world system is filled with corrupt people who will do almost anything to acquire material things. Often, the one who seeks to fight corruption with the truth is said to be a rebel and thus hated by many. And in certain situations, you may even find yourself asking if being honest is worth it at all. Jonathan Bennett, a certified counselor, advised that if telling the truth will make you unsafe or ruin your reputation or cause general headaches, keeping quiet is always an option. While authenticity and honesty are important, not everyone is entitled to your honesty. Even your trusted allies may betray you when you decide to be honest. Therefore, to stand in the path of truth, you must be wise, courageous, and prepared to have more foes and haters. Yet still, you must always learn to understand people and be tactful with the truth. 2. Acting too nice. Have you ever experienced or met someone nice to a fault, but still hated by many people? Have you ever wondered why? Although it makes logical sense that the nicer you are, the more appealing you will be to people. However, a study carried out by Washington State University in 2010, in which students were selected to participate in a game for a test for altruistic behaviors, proved otherwise when, after the experiment, most of the participants said that they would not want to work again with their unselfish teammates. Some said the unselfish teammates made them look bad. Others suspected that the unselfish ones had ulterior motives. It is not out of place to be nice, it's just that most people get irritated when you are too nice to them. There is often this disposition that you are being too nice because you want to get something from them. So instead of them to reciprocate your niceness, they turn out to be mean and hateful towards you. Furthermore, maximum times when you are nice, you unknowingly intrude into people's space and personal affairs. This is also very annoying and may lead to a hate attack. 3. When you are partial. The Cambridge Dictionary defined partiality as the fact of unfairly preferring or approving something. Being in a leadership position and not being fair to all is one reason why you might receive hatred from your subordinates. Nobody likes to be oppressed or treated unjustly. Thus, those who perceive that they are partially treated by you will hate you, and also the people you tend to be biased towards. Partiality is an attitude that causes envy and hostility amongst a group of people. In all you do, you must attempt as much as you can to be fair and uphold equality towards others. 4. Pride. There is nothing wrong with taking pride in your achievements. Yet still, if you allow these things to define who you are and your action towards people, you are setting yourself up in a position to be hated. Buddhist psychology insists that suffering is generated when a person clings too tightly to things that will inevitably pass. Most times, the feeling of pride comes from outward accomplishments. A genuine feeling of self-worth is based upon validating and affirming who you are and being conscious of how you treat others, even with your achievements. No one wants to be looked down upon, therefore, most people tend to avoid you. To be full of pride means to place yourself above others and even attempt to intimidate or oppress. This is one reason why people tend to dislike their bosses and other people who are in high places. Pride has been referred to as one of the 7 deadly sins because it creates an unequal and unhealthy gap between us as humans. If you notice that people hate you, do well to examine yourself and your esteem. 5. Extremely principled. Have you ever wondered why most students hate their teachers, especially their mathematics teachers? Most times, they even call them wicked. Nonetheless, they are not wicked. They are just principled and very strict. If you are principled, many people will hate you. But is it wrong to be principled? No, it is not wrong. But many people do not like to abide by rules, and so they do not like people who are strict with rules. On the other hand, it may be that your principles are rather too rigid and quite forceful. If this is your case, then you have to apply a bit of flexibility in your dealings with others. Furthermore, research shows that stern people are less likely to smile. They are almost always straightforward and feel insulted by innocent jokes. This attitude of not smiling repels people and causes them to generate a feeling of hatred for you, even though your principles are correct. Learn to see things from other people's perspectives. Remember, the goal is not to be liked by all, but to be better. 6. Always claiming to be right. Sticking to some particular beliefs and practices which make you despise other people's opinions can also cause some people to hate you. If you are a know-it-all kind of person, you will always want to make out points. And in the process of wanting to claim to be right, you most times end up proving others wrong. Nobody likes to be embarrassed at all times. Hence, they generate this ill feeling towards you and will abstain from sharing ideas in your presence, or they may even try to avoid you. It is acceptable to air your opinions, but publicly or rudely making other people feel like their opinions is trash is something you should not do. 7. Humble bragging. This attitude stems from pride, although it does not necessarily have to do with looking down on others. Humble bragging is a term used when someone brags about themselves in a way that is disguised in complaints or humility. It is an act carried out by cunning people when they do not want to promote themselves straight up. Some of the statements made by a humble bragger include, "I hate that I am a nice person. Everyone wants to be friends with me." Or, "Why do I always have to do the most important task?" The findings of a research which was carried out on this subject, which was published on the Journal of Personality and Social Psychology, stated that people preferred normal self-praise and even complaints to humble bragging. When you humble brag, many people assume that you are deceitful and only seeking attention. Jane Austen's quote from What Else, Pride and Prejudice perfectly explain how people perceive humble bragging. It says, "Nothing is more deceitful than an appearance of humility. It is often only carelessness of opinion and sometimes an indirect boast. You may think humble bragging is the best way to get liked, but unfortunately, it is the reason why people do not actually like you. Instead of saying, 'I wish I were selfish,' people will ride on me as much as they complain from a humble bragging. You can instead say, 'Jane took my generosity for granted,' a common complaint." And just before you go, watch other videos on YouTube. If you are an entrepreneur or an ambitious person, we invite you to join our motivational channel. The objective of the channel is to give you daily inspiration so that you will have the strength to pursue and achieve your most important dreams. We call this channel Hunt TV, and you can join in the description box. We love you.